I'm going into my final semester of my computer science degree, and I decided to make a list of tips that I would give to future computer science students. My first tip would be to create your own practice projects. Your classes will go over the basics of a lot of things, but they never dive deep into any one subject, and that's why you have to go figure out random side projects that will get you deeper into those topics. My second tip is to know what resources you have available to you. There are many great resources online that you can use to learn almost anything for free. I made a list of all the websites that I found useful, and I put a link to that list in the description. I haven't used all the resources listed on the site, but I have used most of them. And if you're new to programming, I'd suggest using Codecademy and Udacity or Coursera. I've used all three of them and I found them to be very informative with their step-by-step tutorials. My third tip is to learn how to study properly. I've found that the way that you need to study for computer science classes is actually much different than most of the other classes I've taken. This is because you need to memorize definitions, you have to learn the facts, and you also have to learn how to make the programs work while learning different programming languages. And when you combine all these, it makes it into a combination of how you would study for almost every other class put together. For the facts part, I usually use just regular flashcards to remember all the facts. I use Quizlet to make the flashcards. And you could even study them from there too, but I like to take it one step further. And I put my flashcards into a software called Anki. And what Anki is, it's a systematic repetition software, and it shows you the cards right when you're about to forget them. And it's been proven that that helps build stronger connections in your brain. The way you do that is you have to get a plugin in the Anki app if you're interested in doing this, and it actually imports your flashcards from Quizlet into Anki. I found using this technique to be one of the best ways to memorize definitions for the long term, because in computer science you can't just forget things after you learn them. It goes into the next class. Each class builds upon the last. Normally with like a regular science class like biology, you probably only take one of those and you could forget it after you're done. With computer science, throughout all 4 years, each class builds upon the last one, and they assume you already know everything from your previous classes still. So memorizing those definitions using Anki and spaced repetition can help you retain that information throughout all 4 years and even longer. And when you get stuck on your programming assignments, try not to look them up, or when you look them up in a way that you're not just copying and pasting the answer. Look up the pieces that you need. Don't just try to copy and paste your full assignment into Google and see someone else who did the same thing. While that may seem very tempting to do, you just won't retain the information and you won't learn anything. That's really bad for computer science because, as I said before, you need that information to keep building on itself. And if you just skip something once, you'll definitely need it in the future. Just think through the problems and you'll do much better that way. Another really useful thing you could learn to study better is taking the course on Coursera called Learning How to Learn. I found this helped me immensely. This course teaches you skills that you will probably use for the rest of your life, so I think it's worth the time to put it in now so you could learn to study more efficiently. My fourth tip is to go beyond what you learn in class. Most of your classes won't teach you enough to have a lot of skills to put on your resume. This is something I really wish I knew from the beginning, because I always figured the future classes would give me more skills in different things. But like I said in the beginning, you really learn all the basics and you have to do your own side projects. But this step's a little different than that one, because I'm saying go beyond what you're learning in the class. Go deeper into each topic. When you get an assignment on something, just try something different about it. Like, test it out your own way and see, oh, does this work? Just experiment. Experimenting in computer science is probably the best way you can learn, because you're not just listening to the teacher say something, you're actually trying it for yourself and then modifying it to see if you could do something with it. And this is where you could try to take some of those courses that are on those websites from the resource list that I made. Just taking a few of those courses can help you give you a very good understanding about certain languages that you're interested in and how to make whatever projects you feel like. My fifth tip is that you shouldn't cram for CS tests. I feel like I'm repeating myself over and over again, but the reason you shouldn't do this is because your classes will build upon each other. So when you cram for a test, you're going to forget the information right after it. You want to use those flashcards and practice your programming throughout the whole semester so you keep that information up to the test and after it. So to avoid cramming for your test, try to set aside some time each day, make it a goal or something where you make a few flashcards and then you study them for like 10 minutes. And that's all it really takes. I've done this before in a few of my classes. I would make it a goal to make 5 flashcards a day, and then I would make it another goal to study flashcards for 10 minutes. In total, it took less than 15 minutes a day, but it made it so easy to memorize all the information for way longer than a year. My sixth tip is that you should make a plan before you actually start programming. I know it can be tempting to just jump into a problem or an idea that you have and just start coding right away, but if you do that right off the bat, you're gonna get so jumbled up in your own head, and it's gonna just confuse all the processes, and you'll have to keep going back and redoing parts that you've already done. The better way to do it is just lay out all the things that you need up front in the beginning. Make a list of all the features you want to have. Maybe make a flow chart showing how parts are going to work with each other. And then once you have this all fleshed out on paper, you could start actually programming. When you do this, you'll realize it will save so much time and it'll make you a more efficient programmer. My seventh tip is to avoid procrastination. Procrastination in computer science is not a very good mix, because in computer science, it can be very difficult to judge how long something's going to take you. There have been some assignments I've had where I'm almost done. I think everything's working fine. Then I find one problem at the end, but I have no clue where it is in my code. It could just be one line of code that causes 2 to 3 hours of digging through and finding that one problem. And if I waited till the last minute to find this, I would not have been able to hand in this assignment on time. I would definitely try to give yourself like a 1 day buffer period where you try to do the assignment a day before you normally would. And if something goes wrong, you have an extra day to fix it. My eighth tip is to learn how to use GitHub. GitHub is a website that you could use to store all of your programs in repositories. And you could also call those repositories from any computer and you could share them with anybody. I'd say you should start using GitHub as soon as possible because it can be very useful in future job interviews. There's a few good tutorial videos on how to use GitHub. I actually like using the GitHub desktop app also. Some people don't like that though. They like doing it right from terminal and stuff like that. If you want to learn more about it, I would recommend looking up some tutorials on YouTube or on those resource websites like Coursera, Udemy. All those websites should have great tutorials about GitHub. Any of the links that I mentioned in this video are in the show notes on my website, which I'll link in the description below. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.